hands and call upon the Holy Ghost to be with us, to speak to us. O Holy Ghost, you are the gift of Jesus to us, to reveal all the secrets, all the truth that will set us free. You said, if the Son of God sets you free, you will be free indeed. Lord, here we come. Little sheep I am, coming to your holy presence, Lord. Gently lead us to the truth, Lord. Lead us to your life, Lord. Lead us to your still waters that you have kept for us. Our lives are broken and wounded and disturbed, Lord. But you are telling us you want to give us peace, joy and salvation. Please show us, Lord, what is the connection? If you are our God and give us peace, salvation, why our lives are so much full of misery, pain-filled, sick-filled, Lord? Holy Spirit of God, guide us. Jesus, Good Shepherd, lead us, Lord. Little sheep I am, holding thy hands, O Lord, my good shepherd, my Lord Jesus, gently lead me on.
Little sheep I, holding thy hands, O Lord, my good shepherd, my Lord Jesus, gently lead me on.
Through the streams of living waters, lead me on, Jesus.
Through the streams of living waters, lead me on, Jesus.
Through the green pastures, lead me on, Jesus.
Through the green pastures, lead me, Lord Jesus.
Little sheep I am, needing thy hands, O Lord, my good shepherd, my Lord Jesus, gently lead me on.
Little sheep I am, holding thy hands, O Lord, my good shepherd, my Lord Jesus, gently lead me on.
Lead me on, lead me on, my good shepherd, lead me on.
Lead me on, you lead me on, my good shepherd, you lead me on.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Be with us. Guide us, Lord. Jesus, you are with us. Open our eyes to you, Lord. Open our hearts to your truth, Lord. Open us to your life that you have brought to us, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Mary, our blessed mother, kindly intercede for us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray to you, dear Father.
Amen.
Amen. My dear friends, thank you for watching this holy mass, participating in the mass, and giving us the privilege to minister to you. In today's gospel, John chapter 14 verse 3, Jesus says, I will take you to myself so that where I am, you may also. The heart of God is that he has created us and he wants us to be with him always. But while we are on this earth, he says, whatever happens, remember this truth. John 17, 21, he said, I want you to be with me wherever I am. And wherever you are, I am with you. You have to appropriate my presence by your faith. You have to make alive this truth that I am with you by your faith in me. This is the good news God gives to us. In John 14, verse 1 to 2, he says, but when I look into your life, you are a disturbed person. Your hearts are wounded. Why? I have spoken to you the truth. But in reality, your hearts are troubled. Your hearts are disturbed. Your hearts are wounded. That means in all these moments, you are trying to handle your life by yourself and I have no place. What has happened to your life? He says, let not your hearts be troubled. This with a great troubled heart, the Lord is saying. Because even if I go, I will return to you through the Holy Spirit. That's what he said. I will go to my Father and I will ask the Father. And the same Jesus Spirit will come back to you. And he will make your heart his temple. Whenever you need, whatever may be your situation, when you call upon me, you will know that I hear you. I will show you the way. I will guide you, direct you. But you see the problem. You get stuck up with the problem. But why you don't call me? Why you don't believe me? Why don't you get into my strength? Why are you moving around your weakness? Zacharias 9:12. Why do you move around your weakness? Someone said, today's problem is not because the evil is so strong, but people don't magnify, people don't manifest the good that lives in them. They don't stand for the good. They don't live for the good. They don't celebrate the good in them. Yes. Not that the darkness is so powerful. People don't lit the light whom God has given to us. Yes. That's why the Lord says, I will return to you. And I am going to prepare a home for you. Because your life on this earth is not permanent. Why are you bothered about that which is not permanent and lose that which is eternal? This is the word of God, the Lord says, that where I am, I want them to be with me. This is the prayer he prayed to the Father in John's Gospel chapter 17, verse 22 to 23. So Jesus tells us today, please understand my love for you. I am God Almighty. Wherever you are, I am there. Call on me. As he said in Jeremiah 33:3, call on me. This is the secret. Don't handle your life by yourself. As he said in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5, it is true that we are on this earth. But know the truth. With the instruments and whatever is available from the world, you can't handle the problems which is brought to you by the enemy or by the world or by yourself. You need the heavenly ornaments to guide you and to bless you. to be with you. Yes. Without that, without the heavenly power, you can't handle the earthly problems. Know the truth and come to me. Call upon me. This is the secret. Don't handle your problem by yourself. Call on me and I will answer to you. And I will reveal to you. When you call upon me, let not the problem is calling on you. The situation is disturbing you. The problem asks for greater challenges. The problem is making you to do many things. Okay. But you don't handle your life by yourself. Because I am part of you. You are part of me. And only both the parts together can handle the life on this earth. That's why in James 4:8 he said, draw close to me. You have to draw close to me. And I will draw close to you. And the life comes from there. So the Lord says very clearly, build up your faith in me. Even when I am not seen, even when you see your problems are going beyond yourself, even when you see the answer is not come, delaying is not denying.